Yeah.
2 inches.
I got you.
Is that a street bike?
Place we're in, but pretty much starting in the back. Got a couple other people out here. I know I saw Marshall Fox on the start line, and the only row behind this is the pit bike class. So we actually got one of my biggest sponsors out there, Meredith Vestal, running the KLX 110 out there in the pit bike class. Also, Seth Fisher was out there. Thank you. some property and have put in a driveway or something like that. So a little bit different, but definitely did a great job with the layout today. Flowed really well. Was just having a blast out here. If you guys want to learn a little bit more about this bike that I'm riding, I do have some build videos on the 96 XR100. It's definitely not a stock XR100. Woo! It was pretty funny to just see some of the reactions out here when you go by somebody and they're trying to figure out what the heck just passed them on the trail. Talking about reactions, whatever this guy is on, that was pretty wild to see. But shout out to Keith Mitchell. Probably one of the original people to run an adventure bike at a North Carolina Hirschrauber. He had been out here at Denver a long, long time ago on his KTM adventure bike. This thing sounds wicked though. I give it to him, he's running pretty good out here. Especially with that, whatever that thing weighs, with 600 to 800 pounds, maybe. Drop that on her and try to pick it up. Woo! Good burn over there. For those of you who aren't familiar with North Carolina Hirschrambles, this is a big bike race. At 3 o'clock, this is not designed for super minis. So pretty much most of what you're going to see out here is these big bikes, 250s, 450s, 125, 252 strokes. So that's what makes it a little bit interesting to be out here on a vintage trail bike. This is the old body style with the no fairings on the tank and the kind of square shaped fenders and front plate. I just love the retro look. Section in the heart of it. So it's really fun trails out here. Is breast cancer awareness month. So you'll see some tutus and some pink decals out here. That happens a lot in the Hirschrauber racing community. Started picking up some speed, so a little bit of a longer video. Some of my favorite content is towards the end, so definitely stay tuned for some great footage. That's really too when I started just ripping through here on this little bike. It's a good feeling when you can find another way and capitalize and make a pass.
Yo!
air scramble. Didn't really let off for very long, so it was really giving this bike all it had for that amount of time. And this is just an air-cooled XR100, so these things are tough. It did just fine. It didn't seem to be running too hot or anything, so I'm really happy with how it performed out here. There's a fun spot down here by the crane. It's like some open trail out here. On the next lap, you'll see if they hit it. But next thing I'm going to do is probably put a oil cooler, external oil cooler on the bike. Just make me feel a little bit better about riding it this hard for this amount of time. Really built it more for motocross racing, you know, quick 15-20 minute motos. This is a little bit extreme, I'd say, demanding out of the bike. Just having a ball out here, hooting and hollering, and just seeing the people see the XR100 for the first time. Working our way back over to the creek crossing. I know y'all are jealous if you weren't here, just seeing this trail and just seeing how good it was. So coming through the first lap, and I want to say there was 26 people in this unlimited 25 plus class coming through sixth place. So I'm pretty happy with that so far. It's gonna give me some motivation to keep pushing and seeing what we can do. Finally, it's an open trail out here to open it up. It can be difficult to get in a group when you have people all up in front of you. So this is one of the spots that's a little bit different than it's ever been. You can see some infrastructure going on out here. Really changed a little bit about the start line. Sure what happened to Buddy there, but we're gonna go ahead and go around. Shout out to the photographers that were out there. One of my favorite little spots right here, just right next to the parking lot. It's pretty straight little sections for fun to just roll right through and some little jumps. They didn't have to do a gas stop, so that was cool. Wasn't too sure actually how long the bike could go without filling up, and I think I still had about half a tank afterwards, so pretty happy with that. Really impressed with the suspension out here. This bike was surprisingly smooth. I've done some things to it, but still these forks are traditional, just dampening rod and spring forks. So pretty cool to see them out here performing on a trail that's being raced by some modern technology. see the disc brake though, so this is not an actual XR100 front end. This is off of a KOX 140. Definitely helped out a lot with the stopping power and having that in the front. If you're out there spectating, I'm sure you would have noticed I was just wearing some khaki pants and a t-shirt with a mountain bike helmet as well, so I pretty much added to the element for the full package there. Hopefully y'all enjoyed it. About halfway through the video, I got another older bike here, KDX 200 looks like. Sorry to this guy, I did not mean to really push you off there. Just nowhere to go really with these deep ruts. Up and sore. Stay up on two wheels through there every lap, so that's a good positive. Marshall Fox, you'll probably see him a little bit. Surprising how long it took him to catch up to me. I did let him by after a little bit, but once I knew he was back there, I tried to show him a few lines. Maybe he learned something. It's one of the roughest spots of the trail I am. Just coming down that hill and going up through here. Not sure what it was, some real sharp edge braking bumps. All this stuff was just so fun. These turns are just flowing nicely. Skipping off to some really good stuff right here. I think this is where I'm trying to run from Marshall. So it was about, I want to say, 44th overall, somewhere around there. I did end up getting a top 5 finish in this big class. So that was pretty cool. ATM, but this is one of my biggest, I don't know what you would say, contenders out here. I don't know what class he was in, but it was fun to ride with him. We were trying to keep up with him. I think I ended up finishing ahead of him later in the race. Once I got close, I decided to make a little pit stop right quick. I didn't have any kind of camelback on me today, so I was getting a little bit thirsty.
Holy shit. On your left. On your left.